We have been on Drummond Avenue since 1920. Fast forward to now, increased violence, young people dying everywhere, getting shot, stabbed. This community is suffering.
I would never come down this street at night today. Tons of drug violence and bullets flying. People continuously get trapped and are products of their environment, but the environment that they are, you know, go back into is this. This is the reality.
We need to reach beyond the four walls of the emergency room, the four walls of the hospital, and into the community to meet their needs. And Project Heal is a quintessential example of that.
It was a hard time when I got shot. My son standing right on the side of me, shot me right there. I wasn't able to go back to work and really provide for my family.
I was in an abusive relationship and I was trying to get out. And my ex, he decided to come back and shoot me 10 times.
A peer who has been an impacted individual themselves is the person that is going in and speaking to the injured person.
After they connect with the individual, they work closely with our case managers and social workers to conduct an intake, develop an individualized service plan, and get them the supports that they need so that if what they need is educational opportunities, we can do that for them. If what they need is job training and placement, we can do that for them. If what they need is transportation services, we can do that for them. And if what they need are mental health and substance use disorder services, we can certainly do that for them, and it makes a world of difference.
We can make these connections with you so that you can follow through to really change the outcome. You are a human walking in, and that is enough. And we focus on the human connection more than anything.
You're my brother, you're my sister, and I want to help you. So there's no judgment. It's just let me try to help you where I can. So we do what we can. We do what we can.
Project Heal helped change my life by just being there, and I just felt like I would have went a different route. They helped me grow as a person.
They're not scared to help you. And everything you say to them is confidential.
Unfortunately, in this area, being stuck is a life sentence. You know, Project Heal takes these people by the hand and, you know, do our best to try to get them out of that black hole.
Over 40% of individuals who suffer a violent injury return to the hospital with another violent injury within 5 years. Up to 20% are dead of another violent injury within 5 years. And so it was as stark a reminder as they come that there are cycles of violence and we ought to be doing something to break them.
Any improvement, any ounce of help is worth it. You know, if you see one person doing well, I'm proud of that.
I want to be the drive trucks. I want to own my own business. They looked into it, and to this day I'm in the school.
Violence is often cyclical, and so if we could break that cycle, we could prevent future admissions, future harm. This not only makes clinical sense, it makes common sense.